Right now, we're just gonna flow right into the one-arm swing. Body mechanics exactly the same as a two-arm swing, except oddly enough, we're using just one arm, okay? The purpose or the benefit of doing a one-arm swing is that, one, it works your grip more, because now the same weight that you've been swinging with two arms, now it's in one arm, so it's working the grip. The other thing, too, is the weight's going to want to take you out of alignment, and we're going to force ourselves to stay in alignment. So by doing that, it works your core more. It's a little more demanding exercise than a two-arm swing. Two-arm swing is very important. Whenever it's time to go up in weight and stuff, always go back to two-arm swing. Body mechanics, dial you in, and then you go to one-arm swing. Now, just like we're doing when we're lifting a kettlebell, you know, like we're talking about doing a deadlift, it's exactly the same. Now watch this. It's like, when I'm lifting this kettlebell with two hands, right, tell me, is there anything different between that and body mechanics, you know what I mean? When I go to one, everything still should be nice and square, right? Boom. The only difference is the bell's just gonna travel a little bit, you know, because of gravity. It's gonna be over my shoulder instead of right there. But mechanically, everything's the same. I'm not doing this. I'm not, you know what I mean, and let my body come out of line. Everything's straight, boom, just like that, okay? So let's do this. Let's do, you know, do a deadlift two arms, come back down, do it one hand, come back down, switch, other hand, okay? Just do the deadlift just like that. Do a few reps. Just concentrate on keeping everything nice and square and in good alignment. All right, next progression, this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna start off two-arm swing, right? Just a Russian swing, just like this here, right? Get about two reps in, then take one hand off, okay? But, you know, then go back with two hands, take one hand off. Everything should be the same. So when it comes time to this switch hands, dial it back in, make sure your hips, everything all right, then just work it that way, okay? Notice, like, mechanically, nothing changes. Everything's the same. So start off, do like two swings, two-arm swings, take one hand off, do two swings, two-arm swings, take one hand off, do two more swings, and just do that for a while. But the main thing is you want to concentrate on is that nothing changes when you're going from two hands to one hand, okay? Mechanics are the same. Don't forget about your hips and the fundamentals. Okay, hey, you know, one thing I failed to mention on the swing is what should you do with your offhand, right? The hand that's not in the kettlebell. It technically can go on your hip, but I just say just keep it off your hip. Just keep it away from your body. Just throw it out here for balance, whatever. Wherever it works, just keep it off your body. Because what happens is this, because when you go on the hip, and like, it doesn't take many reps where it starts doing this. People are pushing off that thigh and it's throwing them all off, you know? Yeah, you don't want that. So just right from the get-go, just get that hand away from you.